Welcome to the Google Plus Partner Showcase. My name is Chris Cartland, and I'm a developer programs engineer working on the Google Plus platform. Today, we're very lucky to have with us a special guest.
Hi, I'm Lefteris Haritou. I'm working at Snapette Incorporated, and I'm the lead Android and iOS engineer there.
Yeah, this is really exciting. So since we launched Google Plus Sign-In, we've had a lot of different companies and developers integrate with Google Plus. But one thing we keep getting asked is, well, how's it working, and who's implementing this, and tell me more about what this is like in the real world. So today, we have Lefteris here with us from Snapette to help talk about what it's like in the real world, what it's been like integrating with the product, how that has helped the application. And so we're really excited to get that real feedback from someone as like Lefteris.
Yeah, I mean, we had a great success with Google Plus addition to our application. We've seen great numbers. I mean, we've seen increase on total users that are signing up to our app. It was a very easy integration. The documentation is very clear, and it is a success story basically.
Oh, that's awesome. Can you explain a little bit about your app so we could see why a user would want to sign in, or why do you want the user to sign in?
Yeah, our app is a mobile fashion application, so it socially is core to our application. So we want our users to engage. So one way is through user sign up, and Google Plus has significantly helped here. Because it's a driver for new signups. The more users that signing up with Google Plus and sharing with interactive posts, the more users we are getting on our platform.
That's awesome. So, but before you had Google Plus sign in, have you noticed the change between that time and now after you have integrated it?
Yeah, actually, since we integrated Google Plus, we've seen a bump of about 7-8% on total signups. Mm-hmm. So with Google Plus, more users are willing to sign up to our application and increase our registered users database.
Oh, that's great. And so in order to get that much benefit, how much effort did it take, in your integration?
Yeah, the integration was very easy. We read through the documentation, which is very clear. We benefited from the sample code that is available on the website. Mm-hmm. So it was a very easy implementation, quickly implementation, and effortless. Everything went smoothly.
Oh, that's great. Did you learn anything while integrating that either surprised you, either from the developer's perspective or?
From the developer's perspective, nothing surprised us. I mean, the documentation was there to provide every question and every answer to our questions. And like I said, the sample code was a great startup because you can actually download the sample code and pretty much use a lot of the sample code that's available and just copy-paste it inside your app and get you quickly starting.
That's great. Yeah, so when you've added Google Plus sign-in, but you had other ways for a user to sign in before, and mm-hmm. I was wondering if you've noticed how that has compared to the previous ways the user could sign in.
Yeah, our app is social, so we had various ways of signing up to our app. So in the Android platform, we've seen actually that since Google Plus is available, that about 40-45% of our users are using Google Plus to sign up to the platform. On iOS, the numbers are a bit lower, but still they are about the same with our other social providers. So it's actually doing very well on that part as well.
Mm-hmm. That's very good. And between all of these providers, once you've added it, do you have any numbers about like what the increase has been from before and after?
Yeah, in total signups, we went from 43% of total users signing up on the app to 50%. And as numbers, it's like I said, 45% on Android, 45% are using Google Plus, and mm-hmm. on the iOS platform, 29% are using Google Plus.
That's great. So you actually went from less than half of your visitors in your app had signed in to now you have more than half.
Exactly.
Have actually signed in.
Exactly.
And this is a great way of converting. I guess you have visitors within your app to actual users.
Exactly, and that's what we are trying to do. So we are trying to engage the users to sign up and get them back to the app. And this is one way.
Oh, that's very good. Cool. And then, so we've talked a lot about like sign-in, mm-hmm. And that's getting a user to become a full user in your app. And then once they're there, you mentioned a little bit about interactive posts and sharing. So I was wondering if you could talk a little more about that integration.
Yeah, we use both interactive posts and moment sharing in our app. So every activity you will have, every social activity that will take place in our app is going to be shared on your moments. And there is also the interactive post, which is great. We are benefiting from the interactive post capabilities, so we are actually using the deep linking capabilities. So this is also a driver of users to our app, because interactive posts and deep linking help getting users to your app.
Can you tell me a little bit about what's special about interactive posts?
The interactive post was very easy, first of all, implementing it. It's a quick implementation, very easy to implement, and the users have total control over it. So it has been great for us, and it's also helping our application getting more users by the deep linking capabilities in our app.
And there's a call to action button, right, in an interactive post, which is how interactive posts are special from regular posts. And can you tell us what action you chose to put on that?
Yeah, the action depends on actually what you are going to see. So if an item is available for e-commerce purchase through our external links, so it will show the buy label. But if it's something that's not available for buying immediately, it will say the want.
Want, okay. Yeah. So I want this item, and you can click that button if you want it.
Exactly.
And that takes you, of course, deep into the app.
Right.
Helps you download it if you don't have it already, and then you have it. Very good. How did you go about the decision of choosing that label? So I know I've talked with a lot of developers who want to interact implement interactive posts, and it takes them some time to figure out which label to pick, because there's a bunch of them.
For us, it was very straightforward, because we always had the like button, which indicates actually that like is something that you would want. So there was also a discussion whether we call it like or want. So it was a very easy decision for us, making the label as a want. And for the buy, of course, it's very straightforward. I mean, this item is available for purchase, so you might want to buy it.
Great. And for the web component, you've talked about how you talked about the mobile apps. And would you say that how important is mobile to your application?
We are a mobile application, basically, so this is our main part. We have also the website, but the main focus right now is on the mobile applications.
And have you been able to take advantage of or use interactive posts, over-the-air installs in order to help?
This is something that also helped us. We have also added the ability for a user to sign up on our website with Google Plus. So we are also benefiting from over-the-air installation and seamless login.
And how hard, I know that you've mostly worked on mobile, how hard was it for the web team to
The web team didn't have any problems. I mean, there was also example code, which they used, samples available, documentation. So it was very, very easy to implement as well.
Oh, that's great. Is there anything that you've learned through integrating either for Android developers or for companies that want to use Google Plus in their application? Do you have any advice for those kind of people?
My advice is, first of all, go to the documentation website, read the documentation. It's very clear, it's very easy to read. Download the sample code, use that sample code in your application. Take advantage of all the features that are available there. So use interactive posts, use over-the-air installs. Over-the-air installs is very powerful. It will drive people to download your app. So this is certainly something you don't want to miss. And benefit from whatever you can, actually, from the technology. It's easy to implement, and it pays back.
Oh, that's great. And for all the links, we'll post all the links with this video so that you can go find the documentation for yourself at developers.google.com/plus. Is there any other anything else that you'd like to share about your experience with Google? So not just with the integration, but like with using the different different features. How has this made your product better?
The product is, first of all, made better because it's easier for a user to sign up. I mean, we provide another option. Google Plus is very, very popular. Everyone has a Google account, so it helps also users signing up. So this is definitely something you don't want to miss. And the implementation is very easy, so it shouldn't take more, actually, for an experienced developer, more than half a day of implementing, actually, the G Plus implementation sign up on his application, something no one wants to miss, I believe.
Oh, that's great. Great. Well, thank you so much for joining us. It was great to talk to you about your integration, and we hope that the success that you've seen so far continues to make your app grow and turn more of the people who see your app into dedicated users.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, thank you. So we'll be back again every week with Google Plus. Check out the documentation at developers.google.com/plus. If you have any questions about how to integrate, you can join us in our developer community on Google Plus, or you can ask questions on Stack Overflow with the tag Google Plus. So please check out our samples, and thank you so much for watching.